When I was in college, I had a comic strip called Ig Doof, and I went to the University of Maryland where they actually had a really good daily paper called The Diamondback, with a circulation of about 30,000, readership of, you know, somewhere between 40 and 50 a day. And that was a great training ground for me. And I thought that I was going to be able to take that into the grown-up world, right into newspapers. But I hit a wall, mostly because I couldn't draw like a professional cartoonist. And I knew it, and I couldn't do anything about it. So eventually I found it was sort of like a Peter Principle sort of thing, where I said, well, if I draw like a seventh grader, then I'm gonna act like I'm doing that on purpose. So that's where the idea for Greg Heffley and Diary of Wimpy Kid came from. I got this idea for Diary of a Wimpy Kid, and I really wanted to nurture it. I really was not in any sort of rush. So I thought that if it took a year, that was okay, and if it took 10, which is about what it did, that was okay too. So I worked on it and worked on it, didn't show it to anyone at all, and then finally brought a sample packet to New York Comic Con in 2006. And I walked it around. Nobody wanted to see anything from artists holding sample packets, but I just lucked out. Maybe it was fate. I met an editor who had just published a web comic, and my comic started off on the web, a few months before that. And so he was intrigued, and he said right away, "This is exactly what we're looking for." In fact, he responded to it emotionally and visually without reading the copy at all. So he saw it like a kid would, I think.